Hello and welcome to this video made by the students of Department of Chemical Engineering, VNIT Nagpur, on the applications of fluid mechanics in daily life. In this video, we'll be looking at the application in the form of pumps. A pump is a device that does work upon a fluid to impart it with more energy than it initially had. To understand this, let us take the example of a tire. The air inside a tire is at a higher pressure than that of the atmosphere and thus has more energy. To fill this tire with more air, we need to do work upon the air by the means of a hand pump. As we do increasing amounts of work, the pressure in the tire increases. There are various different types of pumps that are used in the modern world, but the most ubiquitous is the centrifugal pump.
Let's see how centrifugal pump works. Now first, let us identify the component. This is a suction strainer. Water enters through it. It strains away all the foreign materials or dust particles. Water goes into the foot valve. It opens up when pressure increases. Water goes through the suction line. This is a suction pipe. Water passes through it. It is a vacuum gauge which shows pressure at that point. The main component in this assembly is centrifugal pump. It has casing, which is outer covering of the pump. This is an impeller. And this is an eye of impeller which is located at the center of that pump. This is a delivery pipe. This is a delivery flange and this is a pressure gauge. This shows the increasing pressure which is happened at this point. This is at hall or at that pump.
Now let's focus on the centrifugal pump. As we can see, eye is located at the center of the impeller. So water reaches first there. Then it goes to the impeller. These are the vanes of the impeller. And it is distributed towards the casing. This is how initial travel happens. Firstly, the distance between the casing and the impeller is much less after this increases. Significance of this casing is that when there is less area or distance between the impeller and the casing is less, velocity of water increases. As it moves further, velocity decreases as area increases. At the end, we can see there is a maximum area. So velocity is less and pressure is much higher. Hence there is high pressure with delivery.
Now let us see some applications of pumps. Pumps are used widely in municipal water supplies, sewage systems, agriculture, in petrol pumps and various other industries. Thus we realize that pumps play a vital part in today's world and the design of this vital component can be done through the study of fluid mechanics.